Wars Black Series figure review. This time it's Cara Dune from the Mandalorian TV show. She stands at just under 6 inches taller, about 14 centimetres in height, and pretty damn cool. Really does look like the actress very much indeed. The front of the packaging gets the Gregory Titus artwork treatment as usual. Come on camera, we're getting a bit of a focus issue here. There we go, a little bit sharper, looking good. Got the little mole going on in the cheek there. It kind of looks like a rebel symbol in some ways. Maybe it is. Looking pretty good. Number 101 in the line is Cara Dune. There on the back of the text here. Veteran of the Galactic Civil War who fought for the Rebellion. Cara Dune is a seasoned warrior who's put her days of military discipline behind her and now has reinvented herself as a mercenary. So there you go, and UPC on the bottom. Now we'll put a link in the description below. I bought this at darksidetoys.com. Packed beautifully, as always. So again, link in the description to them and eBay if they're sold out. And they will sell out quickly at her because Cara is a single in the wave. She's only packed once in the wave, unlike some of the other figures. So yeah, you definitely want to make sure you get that. So let's get a look at Cara. Comes with a couple of weapons that we want to have a look at here. It's three in total. Let's get a look at this first of all, with the camera in focus. And we get this really heavy artillery weapon, kind of like one we've seen for Sand Troopers before. So it kind of looks like an early Sand Troopers kind of weapon. We've seen these way back in the New Hope. But it looks pretty good. We've got some articulation, really, if you want to call it that, I guess. It kind of is articulation, really. There's a little ball joint of plastic in there, and that works on that part of the handle. And up at the top here we've got a little clip which clips on, and you can put it in different places wherever you believe it should go. I don't think there's any particular place it goes, but that allows you to have a bit more flexibility with the weapon and so forth, and arrange it on her in different ways, across her shoulder or holding it and round her arm or whatever it may be. So that weapon's pretty cool, and she holds it quite well. She's also got a weapon in her holster here, which we'll take out. Nice little, tiny little blaster. Let me just focus for a second. Let me get, there we go, a bit of zoom going on. There we go. You can really see a little bit more detail. So some nice sculpt on that. It looks pretty good. Not a lot of detail, but nice sculpt nonetheless. So yeah. Decent little pistol, and that fits in, as I mentioned, into the working holster on her belt. Let me pop that back in, and just hopefully it should be easy enough. And clips on. Yep, stays in pretty well. She gets some nice sculpt on the figure, a lot of nice detail on that fabric, as you can see that kind of padding going on down the thigh. We've got a couple of kind of canisters on the side of her legs, or boots, I should say. The knee pads get a nice kind of chrome effect around it, which looks really good. And the kind of scuffed markings there. Again, that same nice fabric on the other side with the sculpt into it. She's got what looks like blood on her belt there. I don't think that's intentional, but a little bit of silver going on there for the belt buckles. And even the nice sculpt going on in there. It's beautifully done along the chest. That kind of material looks really nice. Bit of weathering around this piece up here, and again even on the shoulders. And she's got a small knife there as well, pretty straightforward kind of brown handle. Not much detail going on, but still nice nonetheless. Got a little grip on the side of it. She holds that quite nicely. Now in the show, at one point I'm sure I saw it goes into the side of her boot in one clip I saw, but we don't have that here, so it's a shame we don't have a place to store that knife, unless you want to just put it through one of these movable, semi-movable parts here. We could, I guess, if I pop that out. Let me see where we can pop that. You kind of could. Yeah, you could do something like that if you wanted, I guess. So, yep, pretty good. But facial sculpt, I think they've nailed it. They've done a really good job. That really does look like a tiny little rebel symbol. Very, very hard to see. In fact, I think it is. I think it's a little tiny rebel insignia. I'll get a closer look at that under magnifying glass. But yeah, I think that's what we've got there. Looks like the little crest on her cheek. Let me see if I can zoom in even further. Hold on one second. There we go. Let's see. 4.0. Can we? Yes, it is. It is indeed. Little rebel tattoo there on the cheek. Nice. Dead giveaway that you're part of the rebellion, I guess. Looking pretty nice on the facial sculpt, though. Pretty good. Definitely the sculpt is there. A little bit of paint splosh in the nose. But other than that, the hair's nice. Nicely sculpted. Sits quite realistically. Looks good. She's got a kind of shaved part of her braid over this side of the head, which is nicely came out in the sculpt. And a tattoo around her arm. Kind of Karelian looking in some ways, like Han Solo's trousers slash pants aspect. And that is pretty much the key features of this figure. Very nice indeed. She has got a ball joint on a hinge up at the top of the neck. And that neck is also movable too, so you get a little extra kind of movement back and forth. The armor on her shoulders is a little kind of limiting, but it's not too bad. As you can see, it's kind of soft on these armors, but you will get a reasonably high kind of movement for that ball joint with the hinge. We don't have a separate bicep, but we do have a single joint at the elbow, which is pretty high, it has to be said. So you can see there, pretty good kind of angle. Let me scoot back in a little bit. There we go. So pretty good going on there. The gauntlet doesn't swivel, but the wrists do, and they've got a back and forth action too. You've got an upper torso, which is pretty good, pretty flexible and limbo going on there. Peg up at the top of the thighs. You can get the swivel cut at the thigh. You've got a double joint at the boot, and you also have a boot cut. Sorry, double joint at the knees, boot cut, and rocking ankles, and pretty deep, generous pecs. Excellent looking figure. I think once I'm all up to episode 3 at the moment in the show, and nothing else has came out as of the time of doing this review. But yes, it'd be very interesting to see what else and when she eventually comes into the show and what impact she has. But she seems to be a big character in the show, that's for sure, according to some of the interviews, etc. But love to know what you think of this figure. Pretty good. I'm very impressed. Looks really good. Kind of action packed. Nice to see more females in the line. There you go. Let us know what you think. Comment below, and if you like it, give it a thumbs up. And again, link in the description below to Darkside Toys and eBay if you want to pick this up. That's it. Let us know what you think, and we'll see you for another review coming up.